Hello and welcome to your English language class. Today in this class we'll be taking up the question answers and book exercise of the chapter The Open Window. I hope you've understood this chapter well. Okay, so the first question is, what was Frampton doing in the village? So the answer to it would be, Frampton Newton was suffering from social anxiety disorder, which was why his doctors had advised him to visit new places and socialize with more people. That is why Frampton shifted to the village. Okay. Second question is, what was the great tragedy that Vera described? So the answer to it would be, the great tragedy was that 3 years ago, on that very day, Mrs. Sappleton's husband and her two young brothers went off for their day's shooting. They never came back. While crossing the moor to their favorite snipe shooting ground, they were all three drowned in a treacherous piece of bog. Their bodies were never found. Okay, so this was the great tragedy. Third question is, why were Mrs. Sappleton's eyes strained to the window? Okay, so the answer to it would be, Mrs. Sappleton was waiting eagerly for her husband and her brothers to return home, as it was getting late in the evening. That is why her eyes were straying to the window. Okay, and fourth question is, was Mrs. Sappleton interested in what Frampton was saying? So the answer to it would be, no, Mrs. Sappleton was not interested in what Frampton was saying. Fifth question is, what did Frampton see through the open window? So the answer would be, Frampton saw through the open window that in the deepening twilight, three figures were walking across the lawn towards the window. They all carried guns under their arms, and one of them had hung a white coat over his shoulders. A tired brown spaniel kept close at their heels. Okay. And the last question is, what was Vera's explanation for Frampton's departure? Okay, so the answer to it would be, Vera explained that Frampton told her that he was afraid of dogs. He was once hunted into a cemetery somewhere on the banks of the Ganges by a pack of dogs. He had to spend the night in a newly dug grave with the creatures snarling just above him. Okay, so these are the question answers. Next question is, look at the quotes in column A, then explain why the speaker says this in column B. First is, then you know practically nothing about my aunt. Vera said these words, and when Frampton said that he hardly knew a soul in the village. Okay, so at that time Vera replied this. Second is, you may wonder why we keep that window wide open on an October afternoon. So this was also said by Vera. Vera wanted to scare the narrator, so she started telling him a fake story. Okay. That is when she said these words. She started the story with these words. Now third is, I expect it was the spaniel. So these words were also said by Vera. Vera wanted to justify that why Frampton ran away as soon as he saw Mr. Sappleton coming back through the open window. Okay. Now next is, think and answer. Read the setting that Vera gives for her story about Mr. Sappleton and his companions. Does the setting make the story more effective? So yes, she gave a lot of details, like Mr. Sappleton will return with his white waterproof overcoat hung over his shoulders. Okay, so yes, the setting that she made the story more effective. Next is, can you think of another title for the story? Why do you think it is a better title? So, you can give another title to the story, like Vera the Storyteller. Okay, because she was a very good storyteller, and her specialty was to make fantastic stories at short notice. Okay. Now next is, know your values. Vera was bored and told Frampton a scary story. She did not know that Frampton was already a very nervous man. What do you think the consequences of her actions were? Vera was a very good storyteller, and maybe it was her hobby to fabricate new stories, and she liked it. But what she did with Frampton, she played a prank, which was quite wrong on her part, because Frampton was already suffering from nervous disorder, and the consequences could have been terrible. Do you think the thought she thought about what happened to Frampton after he got such a terrible shock in his condition? No, I don't think Vera would have given it a thought, because as soon as he ran away, she started telling another story. Okay, so she was not that much bothered. How important is it to think about the consequences of what we do? Can we hurt others when we do something without thinking? No, we must always consider whether what we say and do affects others in a bad way. The consequences can sometimes be quite serious. So we must always evaluate what we are doing with others, or what we are saying to others, because it may hurt them terribly. Okay. Now next is your grammar part. Read these sentences. Here is everyone, said Mrs. Sappleton brightly. Vera always had something to say. So these are indefinite pronouns which are used here. Okay. Words like everyone, someone, anybody, somebody, someone, no one, everyone, anything, something, nothing. These are all indefinite pronouns. Okay. Sometimes we need to refer to people or things without saying exactly who or what they are. Okay. At that time, we use indefinite pronouns. When I came back from work, no one was at home. Okay. Everything was ready for our trip. Somebody please help me, cried the old man. And there is one rule, we use singular verbs after indefinite pronouns, like nobody likes broken promises. So we always consider it as a singular subject. So that is why we use singular verb along with indefinite pronouns. All right. Now here's one exercise. Complete these sentences with everybody, someone, no one, something or nothing. You may have to use some words more than once. One is done for you. Could someone lend me a bicycle for an hour? I want to eat something and get back soon. Second is, everybody is expected to come to school at 8:30 a.m. Third is, there is nothing in this box. It is empty. Fourth is, they need someone to take their child to school every day. And fifth is, nobody has seen Prateek today. I think he has not come to school. Okay. When we refer back to the indefinite pronoun, we use they. Okay. When we are referring to the indefinite pronoun, we always use they. Okay. And not he or she. Like, everybody turned up for the event. They thoroughly enjoyed themselves. Now, B part is, correct the errors in these sentences. Everyone says that you are extremely rude to him. So in place of say, you'll write says, because it is singular verb. Second is, nobody was at home at that time. Var ki jagah kya aega? Was. Third is, if anyone wants hot dosas, they must go to the dosa stall at the corner of SP Street. So in place of he, we'll write they. And fourth is, someone should be able to lend you their calculator. In place of his, we'll write their. Next is your vocabulary. An antonym is a word that means the opposite of another word, that you must be knowing by now. What are antonyms? The opposites. Okay, like sweet is the opposite of sour. Now Let's do this exercise. Find antonyms for these words. Refer to a dictionary if required. Cooked का opposite raw होता है. Exciting का opposite boring होता है. Spicy का opposite bland होता है. BLAND, bland. Okay. And the opposite of powerful is weak. Now, complete these sentences with the new words you have found. First is, eating raw food might be harmful. Second is, this dish has no spices, it is too bland. Third is, she has become weak after her illness. And the last one is, the crowd started leaving since the test match was turning out to be another boring draw. Okay. The dull, and the word dull means something which is boring. Therefore, dull and boring have the same meaning. These words are called synonyms. Now, you must be knowing what are synonyms. Synonyms are similar meaning words. Now, the next exercise is find synonyms for these words. Piece ka synonym, part ho sakta hai, bit ho sakta hai. Okay. Synonym of priceless is invaluable. Okay. Or incomparable or precious bhi ho sakta hai. Bad ka, terrible bhi ho sakta hai, unpleasant ho sakta hai. Okay, you can write any of these words. Hollow ka opposite, empty. Now, hollow ka synonym, empty, right? So, complete these sentences with the synonyms you have found. First is, my sister has an invaluable camera. It was a special gift for her from my parents. Second is, a part of the puzzle is missing. I can't complete the jigsaw without it. Third is, the unpleasant news shocked everyone. And fourth is, she cannot start the vehicle because the fuel tank is empty. Now, next is your spelling part. Adjectives can be formed by adding IVE to certain words. Similarly, verbs can be formed by adding ISC as a suffix to some words. कुछ एडजेक्टिव्स के पीछे आप आई वी ई या आई एस ई लगा के उनको क्या बना सकते हैं, उनको नाउन की तरह यूज़ कर सकते हैं. ओके okay, या फिर उनको वर्ब की तरह यूज़ कर सकते हैं. तो जैसे यहाँ पे आपको कुछ वर्ड्स दिए हुए हैं. री राइट दीज वर्ड्स यूजिंग आई वी ई और आई एस ई. रेफर टू अ डिक्शनरी इफ़ रिक्वायर्ड. मॉडर्न का क्या हो जाएगा, मॉडर्नाइज. Effect, effective. Secret, secretive. Memory, memorize. ISE लगा देंगे, MEMORISE. Express, expressive. Last में IVE लगाना है. Protect, protective. Harmony, harmonize. Create, creative. Okay. So, okay. You just do till here. Okay, you just do all these question answers and the book exercise given here, which I have explained to you, and submit your homework by 3:00 tomorrow. Thank you for watching this video.